welcome back. My name is Rosalind, and this is my Let's Play of Marathon Quest 11, where everything is twice as long as it needs to be. And, add to that fact, it is also overly annoying. Let's proceed on and see how much longer and more annoying everything in this game can possibly get. It's like a game show. Can it get any worse than it already is? If you can't tell, overly long boss fights, status effects that it can't do anything about, I'm so confused. But overly long boss fights, status effects can't do anything about, you know, things like that is starting to really, well, not starting. Is really, really wearing on me. Add to the fact that basically every single side quest in this game is just a boring slog. It's unfortunate because the first half of this game was so enjoyable too. And now it's just like, is it ever going to end? Person? Really? Whatever. Boy, another area where I need to get a flying dragon. Yeah, I don't think I've actually fought one of these. Maybe I have. Ooh, a metal slime. Oh, and there it goes. That wasn't predictable at all. Thank you. Yes, we got new enemies on this side of the dungeon. Totally makes sense that if I attack first, it gets to go before I can take any action. I see. Straight upgrade. Really don't like this map. Goes down in there. Thank you. And Cindy almost has too many spells to choose from. Keep forgetting I have that ability with Martina that does extra damage to mechanical enemies. Great axe. Did we finally get an axe upgrade for Craig? He hasn't gotten an axe upgrade in a while. We do. I see. It's a pretty nice upgrade, too. Oh, I see. It goes with his shield now. That's nice. That's that. Back in there. Let's check out this little enclave here. Anything? Yep. We have materials. Okay. Looks like somewhere back in here we should be getting one of those rideable monsters, because if not, there's really just no way we can get to those ledges. So it has to be one back here somewhere. Yep, just as I thought. Man, that thing hits hard. So the best thing about using claw moves with Martina right now is she, I think she kills, I want to say it's 20%? I knew you can get her up to where she heals 60% whenever she deals damage with claws. Yeah, right now she's healing 20%. With claws. She has this right here. Heals 20% whenever she deals damage with claws. And then if I grab this, it'll be an extra 10%. The reason that the hero is also healing damage, probably should have explained this earlier, is I got this sword from Training in Metals, Metal Academy. Whenever you deal damage, you heal 25% of the damage dealt. It's only for the first hit with the sword, though, so like whenever I use Sword Stance, even if I deal like hundreds of damage with Sword Stance, it only heals so much of it, unfortunately. Otherwise, it would probably be a little too good if he was able to heal for, like, absolutely, you know, just straight up 20% of the damage he deals. Yeah, I had a feeling that was going to drop from this guy. Or from the ceiling. So he healed for 8, but he healed 140. Even though he's supposed to heal for 25%, and that's because he's only healing for the 25% from the first hit with that sword. Oops, that's not what I wanted to do. That was a waste of MP. A bracelet recipes just there. Oh, 1 point away from being able to grab extra 30 defense with Greg. That's unfortunate. That's everything, right? Yeah, because now going back here is where I was before. I've been back down there. So I just go down this area. Right, because I just came from out here. Yeah. Just double check and make sure I don't get turned around. Yeah, I had a feeling I was going to have to get off of the dragon anyways. Is that what we need right there? Yep. That's what I have them. Square Enix always makes this the highest tier metal in every single game that you can you're crafting in. Thank you. And he's just basically saying, you know, trust me, this is definitely Orihatakon. I also heard all about it from Maya. She wouldn't, you know, basically she kept just telling him, like, this is the rarest metal. You know, he's like, with this you can make a just a ridiculously powerful sword. He's like, oh, I get it. So that's what the hero sword is made of. So now we need to get out of here and go get our hammer. The flute in, let's get on top of our giant flying whale. All right, so we have to go to somebody, right? I believe. Yep. Okay. I guess I probably could have done this from the beginning. Instead of teleporting directly there, I believe I'm going to teleport to this region. Or I guess I could go through the Harune and walk there and kind of show you guys what it's like now that the world is all turning into crap. So maybe that's what I'll do. I did this earlier when I was going around collecting, or not collecting, but reopening teleport locations, going to all the different camps and whatnot. But I'll just, take the path and walk in there as if I didn't do that. So we'll leave through here, and that's where we'll go next. It shouldn't take too long to get there. I've already explored all this quite a while ago, so. But we'll have to start making our way towards Samadhi in the next episode. Gotta get the hammer now to use to forge our Orihatakon. And hopefully make a new hero sword, so. If you're enjoying the series, please leave a like. If you have any questions, comments, or suggestions, let me know in the comment section below. And if you haven't already, please subscribe. It really does help. And I'll see you next time.